Share my perfection with this world! I will make you see!
Yeah. Ah, Aphrodite's palace. The most majestic sight on the Golden Isle's skyline.
I don't know if it's the most majestic. There's one mountain in particular I think is pretty... regal.
Huh.
Did you know this Roostol was once the great Electrios?
Helios's annoying bird that screeches every time the sun comes up?
The very one.
Knock him dead, Phoenix! That dumb bird is the last thing I want to hear after partying with Dionysus.
Ha ha! architect of the Minotaur's Labyrinth. I chased perfection. I murdered my nephew, afraid his genius would eclipse mine. I set my eyes only on greatness.
will make you perfect. You will suffer, but it will be worth it.
You might have offered Paris power, Hera, but it wasn't enough to win the Apple of Discord.
Of course not. It was a total turnoff. Paris didn't want power. He was a slave to love.
Ha! Athena. If Paris had known the Trojan War was coming, maybe he would have taken the battle wisdom you promised him in exchange for the apple. But alas...
Ha-ha! Time paradox!
Wow. You're smarter than I gave you credit for.
Oh, sorry. I nodded off for a second. What was that?
Never mind.
The Apple of Discord. All Hades broke loose over that thing. Three goddesses, toe-to-toe, for the title of most beautiful.
Ah, but our hero knew the apple symbolized more to Aphrodite than a self-regard worthy of Narcissus. That's why she had to win.
Oh yeah? What did Phoenix think it symbolized?
Freedom.
Cleanse this world of divine imperfection!
Ha!
Aphrodite, I have something for you.
I've had enough of your gifts. What I mean to say is, I'm only here to give, not to receive.
But it's another apple for your collection.
It's so beautiful. I want it.
Did you know the Trojan War could have been avoided if Eris had been invited to Peleus and Thetis's wedding?
What? I thought it had something to do with Troy and Greece. The shade Eris was throwing, how did I not put two and two together?
The best parties are the ones that the goddess of Discord shows up to uninvited. Everyone knows that.
Catfight!
To think Hera pulled Athena's hair over an apple. Her own daughter.
Ah, right. The beauty contest. What moron appointed that blowhard Paris the judge?
I'm looking at him.
To be fair, I'd had a lot to drink.
It wasn't Paris's fault. Hera offered to make him king of Asia and give him great riches. Athena offered great glory and renown in war. But show me a god or mortal who could resist Aphrodite's bribe of true love.
Yeah, sure. It was Helen of Sparta's love Paris was after.
So he did exactly what you asked and chose the most beautiful woman. Then, you know, started the Trojan War.
I wanted to win that apple so badly. I wanted to win that apple so badly. I started a war for it. To show Zeus. Everything that came after was my fault.
You were acting according to your nature, Aphrodite.
Which is exactly why I'm better off without my essence. My nature caused only pain.
That's where you're wrong, Aphrodite. You can't have one side of the coin without the other. Your passion, your unpredictability, and I'll say it, your jealousy, your vanity, yes, they caused pain. But you know what else they did?
What?
They created some of the greatest adventures, the greatest epics, the greatest stories the world will ever see. I'm a storyteller, I know. Sure, we would all be safer if we just stayed at home, but everything's more beautiful in color. The passion is worth the pain.
Oh, in that vault are my unfiltered jealousies and darkest natures. If I let you in, everyone will judge me. I've been judged before. Aphrodite, rein it in. Aphrodite, you're too much work. Aphrodite, you're too much trouble! Aphrodite, you're too much!
Whoever said that owes you an apology. What a jerk!
I never meant it like that.
Didn't you?
You don't have to compete for my or anyone's love. You are enough. Anyway, if you're that beautiful and have a perfect personality too, well, honestly, it's just annoying at that point.
All right. I'll move my room. Please, take this blessing before you go in there. You can find me at the Hall of the Gods.
Get off me, all of you! It's enough already! Why don't you just go get a job?
I had no idea Hermes and Aphrodite were so close.
They even had a child together.
No way. Boy or girl?
No.
Ah, I see. The child was non-binary.
Look at you.
Prometheus, I have an amphora collection. I'm with it.
Ah! You're definitely bringing some life back to this dusty old hall, Aphrodite. Plant life.
If I rustle a bit, squirrels will come running. And there's a nest up in one of my branches, so birds soon. Ants, maybe?
Exciting.
I'm here selling, if you're buying.
For anything.
Maybe Hera's just jealous that Heracles wore it better than her. There, I said.
With herself. That's twisted.
Phoenix realized the seeds had to be burned to clear the air.
Coming, Aphrodite. Let's get rid of these seeds. Yeah.
Eros needs to calm down and bow down. There's only room on Olympus for one. Seriously, Persephone, moving back in with your mother half the year isn't the changing of the seasons. She's using you. Grow up!
Thank you.
my fire.
might think he has me locked down, but I'm out here to play.
You'll be back to yourself soon, Aphrodite. As if I could ever love a man like Hephaestus. I mean, that face alone could sink a thousand ships. Oh, down below. Oh, let's just say there's no return.
Telling her to fix that crow's nest she pretends passes for air. Girl, that helmet ain't doing you any failing.
Yes.
Gracious! Great balls of fire!
That's the last scene. Time to get Aphrodite back to her free-spirited self.
I mean to put so much pressure on Aphrodite.
Sometimes we think we're showing love for someone, when really, we're fulfilling our own needs through them.
So you're saying I actually need someone to protect me?
Not exactly, but...
It's so true. I've always had to stay strong for everyone. No one ever takes care of me. Prometheus, it's so hard.
But... I'd hug you, but I'm chained to a rock.
Yeah!
also friends, my lord. He married me off to the first safe falcon and proposed. I deserve better than his bestows.
Not fair. He kind of held me hostage. Which was pretty impressive. I thought, this guy is sun material.
He was already your son.
Well, that was the only moment he lived up to it.
A faint hint of perfume wafted past.
That smell.
Unfazed by the jealous thoughts echoing inside the vault, Phoenix was determined to reunite Aphrodite with her.
I told you I'd get your essence back.
I didn't doubt that. But do you see me differently now that you've heard all my worst thoughts?
Not at all. I'm excited to meet the real you. Because honestly, Hermes's hair is a bit much right now.
Wait, what?
Okay. Then I'm ready.
Your passion and love forever be boundless. Rise, golden goddess Aphrodite.
Speechless? I know.
Can you believe you actually had to convince me to return to this body? Oh, without you, I would have lost the ability to love myself forever.
Actually, I stole that years ago.
Clearly. Looks like you've been loving yourself far too much. Oh, you might want to disinfect that toga.
Oh, glad you're back.
Please, Phoenix. Take my final blessing as thanks.
Ready to defeat Typhon?
I'm more than ready to take down the ugly beast that stole my beauty! But there is one other thing I could use your help with.
What can I do?
There are four mythical beasts Typhon brought out of Tartarus to terrorize the creatures of the Golden Isle. If you could end their reign by defeating them in battle, I would be extremely grateful. Normally, I wouldn't care, but I guess I'm going soft.
I'll take care of it.
Of course you will.